Frontera colombo-venezolana en el sector de Araujita y La Victoria. Allí observamos comunidades saliendo del territorio venezolano tratando de salvaguardar sus vidas.
An exodus of families from Venezuela crossing the Arauca River to seek safety in Colombia. Nearly 5,000 people made the crossing in late March and early April. They were fleeing an offensive by the Venezuelan army in Apure State against Colombian rebels on their territory. We spoke to some of the people who fled. They told us they were afraid of getting hurt in bombardments and afraid the Venezuelan army might mistake them for rebels.
We left because of the bombings. It was traumatizing. In El Ripial, the soldiers were stealing from shops. Homes were being burned. If I'm able to go back, I will. But for now, the Venezuelan forces haven't left yet. We can't be sure that the fighting won't start again. They're saying that the civilians who won't return to Venezuela are guerrilla fighters. We're just scared. We don't want to be arrested or killed.
Human Rights Watch says the Venezuelan army has conducted systematic abuse of civilians, including arbitrary arrests and torture. Their operation is targeting the Frente Décimo, or 10th Front, an offshoot of Colombia's FARC rebels. So far, at least 16 soldiers have been killed and 8 have been taken prisoner. The fighting has eased now and the refugees are starting to return. But regional expert Bram Abus says they face a difficult future.
Vemos que grupos armados han podido penetrar estas zonas de frontera donde pueden traficar bienes, drogas, dinero, armamento de un país al otro país. Los narcotraficantes usan en Venezuela como un trampolín para acceder a mercados internacionales. Y bien, estos grupos armados en la frontera, aprovechando del abandono estatal, ahí ya están décadas a ambos lados, tanto en Venezuela como en Colombia. Trabajan con poblaciones locales que no tienen acceso al mercado formal de empleo y por lo tanto comunidades están casi obligadas a participar en economías ilícitas de sus grupos armados. En Apure hay múltiples grupos armados que están compitiendo en economías ilícitas con grupos estatales que también participan en el narcotráfico. Vemos que la competencia se ha aumentado de tal forma que causó unas tensiones y por lo tanto la Fuerza Armada Bolivariana decidió deshacerse del actor armado que más molestaba. Eso es el Frente 10 de las FARC.